Hey guys, the video you guys are about to watch is kind of long and drawn out. So, if you don't want to watch the full thing, skip through and look at the finished product. Like, share, subscribe. It helps us out a lot. Let's just do builds like that. Without further ado, this video, in the end I said I was going to do a fast thing, but what I edit my videos on doesn't have that, so I'm sorry for such a long drawn out video. If you guys like it, that's cool. If not, click on one of my other videos. Without further ado, here it is. Hey guys, on today's episode of Poor Man's Garage, you guys are going to watch, not necessarily watch, I'm going to show you guys how to clean a console that has rat shit piss on it. You know, my car's been sitting forever, and this is console for our 65 lemans that I picked up Monday for $350, clean title, everything, so, and it runs. Be a video of that here shortly. I'm gonna start filming that hour or two. I'm gonna get outside, show you guys how it runs, and hopefully go for a drive today. That would be really, really cool. But enjoy the video. You guys are gonna love your work. So enjoy it. Alright, console. This is what I like to use. Q-tips. Some paper towels and some water, and you might need a screwdriver or something to get down these grooves. A toothbrush works really good if you have a toothbrush. It works really good here. I don't have one that I could use for this. I only have one that I brush my teeth with, so I'm gonna use this and somebody to cut the console for a rat shit that's in the car. My uncle had got this car in on a trade before he died, so the person he got it from, because I know he didn't mess with it, the person he got it from cut this out and bolted it like Quicksilver ratchet shifter in the car, which in these cars looks kind of jank in my opinion. At least that's my opinion. Some people will say, oh, it looks cool. It's not my opinion. My opinion, the stock shifters in these old cars look good. But yeah, enjoy me cleaning. Sorry for the fan noise. like take a Q-tip like this. See how I pulled the lint off of it? Just worry about damaging your console. It works alright too. But really a toothbrush is what you need. Or one of the things that come in a Dollar General wire brush kit, you got the light one that's not necessarily wire, like a paintbrush. That works good too. You guys can see that dirty. It's nasty. I don't know if it's weird about it because I'm getting out here working on the car here in a little bit. But some people, you might want to put some like rubber gloves on or some shop gloves, like hand gloves. Just because, you know, I have to end up washing my hands tonight here in an hour or two. Anyways, so I'm not too worried about it. But like I said, if you're kind of, you don't like to get dirty and you just want to keep your hands clean, then you want to put on some gloves. I mean, but I'm not too can't worried about it. not have a key for it, it's locked off. Put that stuff in here. I don't know what the new lock that comes with the little plumb. Taking apart this car, guys, especially like a console, never throw something like this lock away, because when you buy the new one, you don't know if it's going to come with this piece. So what I like to do is keep everything till, like, let's say I'm working on a console, I like to keep everything till this console is all together, especially container part. Never throw this away until this is done. That way, and even if, like, let's say you buy a new one, but they send you the wrong one, then you'll have this one to look at and be like, well, hey, what's the wrong part? Alright, you guys. Let me do this real quick. Now, this car will never be a show car. First of all, I don't have the money to build a show car. Hopefully one day soon I'll be able to build one. But if you were doing a show car on this car, like a trailer queen, something wasn't going to be driven, it wasn't going to see anything. Now, this is going to be a driver. It's going to be a nice driver, you know. Parts, I'm not looking for perfect. This car isn't going to be judged. It's not going to be go any events and win any plaques or nothing. It's just going to be a driver. I'm not too worried. I cleaned it up the best I could. Chrome's fitted. I mean, it's a driver console. It's not perfect. It's not a show console. If you're building a show car, you don't take, let's just say, this piece right here. This piece right here. You'd want to take that out and either have it, have you either re-chrome it and then paint it black. And then both, or find new, old stock, or even if they reproduce, I'm not even sure if they reproduce. But, and both that, you know, have a new console. But, leave the car, I ran the VIN. Title said it was a long scored. And the body tag and VIN verified that, I guess. So I'm not sure what else comes with lemans sport, coupe sport, or whatever, sedan sport, something like that. Something sport. Basically, my gather, it's the SS version of Pontiac's SS version, you know, compared to Chevelles and all that other bullshit. But without further ado, here is the console. Like I said, we will be doing probably a starting video of it starting, that finish this other video up, and then hopefully get it driving. But for $300, I mean, you can't complain. I got a deal on it because it was my aunt, or my cousin, step cousin. My uncle gave the car to him when he was, I think he was 6 or 7. And then shortly thereafter, my uncle had passed. I was supposed to buy this car in a 64 or 5 Catalina with it. But the kid changed his mind, decided to keep the car, which is fine, you know. And I was supposed to buy both of them for $500. The Catalina's pretty hashed. I mean, the frame was shot. I mean, you jack it up, and the frame would just crumble in your hand. But this car has a good frame, which I'll show you guys on the other video. It has a good frame. Floors are good except for one toe pan, or floor pan, where your feet go in the front driver's side. Somebody took a freaking torch and cut a hole in it for some reason. I'm not sure. It does need like fenders, lower quarter skins, trunk pan, but it's worth putting the money into. I mean, 65 lemans sport, too. I'm not sure how many of those are left in existence. I'm sure probably quite a bit, but I bought it for $300, and I didn't even know this console was in there. I thought I was going to buy one, and it just so happens that I lifted up something behind the seat and just was sitting here. It's kind of cool because the part I don't have to buy. And consoles, when you're looking at like consoles and you want to buy like a new one, they remake a new one. Like my Malibu out here and the Mustang, consoles are reproduced, but Malibu is kind of expensive to, you know, you have to buy the base and then you have to buy the top pieces and it just gets out of hand. So that one I'm going to wait and try to find one on eBay. But again, the This video is probably dragging on yet 31 minutes long. So I'm gonna do like some fast plays and shit on this. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Like I said, just take your time. You know, try to get the best that you can get it with what you have available. And a lot of the stuff on this car, I don't think my uncle necessarily did it. The dude he got it from had rigged a bunch of crap up that just needs to be done away with and put back to original. You know, like they put a clickety-clack like AutoZone fuel pump on the frame because they didn't want to buy the mechanical fuel pump that was on the block. And they have that rigged up with a wire, and then the wire runs into the car to a switch, which I just don't like. A bunch of just idiots. I mean, if you're going to work on a car, guys, and this is, I'm going to see this because I can rant about this all day. Just use common sense, you know? You really want, like on this, I'll give you guys some updates on this here in a minute. But like that, do you really want to have somebody pop the hood and be like, you see, nice valve, it's a painted block, you know? And then you look on top, there's wire strung everywhere, and just, it looks trash. You're not going to win any awards with a truck like that or a truck car like this the way you're going to build it, unless you build it to win awards. But you also don't want somebody to pop up and go, oh my God, what were you thinking? You know what I mean? You want somebody to pop up and be like, oh, that's cool. All right, let's go guess what it's on this truck there. All right, guys. So, as you guys see, we got the big block here. We are waiting on, we are putting roller rockers in it along with screw-in studs. Then, along with that, we have to order gas line, which I still haven't ordered yet. Been really busy. Nothing's really been done except I put the fuel pressure regulator